Hello everyone. Today we are going to cover the second lesson from this 101 Promise Oath Keeping book written by Neil Escalin. His second chapter is I will be a role model for my children. So the startling fact that parents ultimately discover is that children are instinctive mimics. Instinctive means instantly they will copy our talk, our behavior, everything, our habit also. No matter how much we tell them otherwise, they'll act just like us. That's very true. Whatever you say, you do this way, that way, they cannot able to receive, because at that age their age is to see and learn. Definitely their learning processes, their listening processes also there, but maximum they are acting, maximum their behavior changes by observing only. The English poet John Wilmot confessed, "Before I got married, I have 6 theories about bringing up children. Now I have 6 children and no theories." What a great thing he has told. Before marriage, we plan a lot. We'll treat our children like that. But we never try to change ourselves, try to change our behavior, because the most important thing is that the children copy to us. How they definitely copy through their surrounding. To their mom and dad, definitely they will copy their behavior, their theory, their hobbies and all. What is needed is not a crash course on how to raise great kids, but rather than how to be great examples. We definitely set the examples. Through the example only they learn a lot. Every mom and dad needs to see them as a prototype that will soon be reproduced. Prototype means just like if you say mobile phone, its first version is the prototype. Rest all will copy it of this first version and upgrade it also. So parents are also the prototype. They are the first version. The children is the second version, which will be upgraded by their caring and all. Good or bad, they will be good or bad, honest or deceitful, moral or immoral, we set the standard. I like that Joe Billings said, "Train up a child in the way he should go and walk there once a while." Definitely, teach them how to behave, we also have to work with them. We have to be present with them. We have to spend time with them to observe their behavior and to polish them so that they can able to shine in the society. Weaving the fabric. Let's see. The topic of family values should never be issue or debate. Every family has values, definitely values. That should not be the issue of a debate. Means this value must not be a topic of the debate. There are not two choices. We either raise the children in a home with strong moral principle, author is saying, we'll raise our children with moral principle, or we have chores just without any discipline, without any manner. Children, they will throw their clothes here and there, they will not complete their assignment and homeworks in proper time, they will not behave respect the elders, means just like chores. Ken Canfield, president of National Center for Fathering, believes that the challenge for his generation is to make marriage a prerequisite to fathering. It's a commitment for the children to set the best example for them. By changing our shape, our attitude, our behavior, day-to-day routine, our way of talking, the words we are uttering, everything will be copied by them. So we should be the best example for them. Says Canfield, every day hundreds of children born without parents. It's a matter of sorrow. Who are committed to building a solid family together. Many children are born daily, born up, without a permanent parents. So, and that children they grown up here and there, and later what happens, everybody knows they commit the most crime cases. Research confirms that these children are more likely to commit delinquent acts, means criminal cases, drop out of school, because behind them there is no strong examples for them to which they can copy, so they involve in these activities, wrong activities. Have children out of wedlock, same process they also follow. Suffer from poverty, receives welfare, and abuse drugs and alcohol. Nowadays young generation are coming into it due to this problem, because the parents could not, just they like to tell what to do, but they are not doing the way they should behave. For that purpose the children also copy them. They don't listen to them because they just like to copy you. We may not be able to transform the world, but we will make a permanent imprint on our sons and daughters. We alone, if you want, we can. Yes, it's not possible to complete all the mentality of the children in this world, but definitely we can grow our single child or in our children properly. As David Wilkerson, founder of Teen Challenges, states, every word and deed of a parent is a fiber woven. Here fiber woven is suggests to the society into the character of the child, which ultimately determines how that child fits into the fabric of the society. So we should always set the best example. We will act before them positively. We will work with that great discipline. We should get up early. We should take our food properly. We should behave with, means if the dad should behave with his wife, and wife should behave with her husband properly. Definitely that must be there. We should, every love and respect must be there, so the children will learn the same thing from the parents. They will serve, means in and they can able to make them a good person in this society. So are you setting the example? Here is the all about this second lesson. I'll be a role model for my children. So if you want to listen or see my videos for the first lesson and the introduction part, I am also giving in the description. You can go to there, visit to there, and click on the links to see my other videos. And if you want to purchase this book also, this book's links I am giving in the description, you can directly buy from there. So this is all about his second lesson. In the next video we are going to cover his third lesson. I'll be treasure the time I spent with my family. So thank you very much. Thank you for watching.